have with us Mr. Zan. Hey. How are you, sir? Hey. As well as Kitch.
Hey, what's up?
Right? In a different setting. Mm-hmm. Football.
Yeah, football. You know, football, good vibes. Yeah. Everybody come out for the support of the chat buns. You know what I mean? Come out, have a good time.
Yeah, that's basically it. You know, my boy Baker, he's always put together the celebrity team and them fet match and them. And you know, when he call on you, you gotta come out and answer, you know. You gotta come out to the call because it's also good for fitness too. On the next side of the job now, on the real side of the world. But we don't get to do that again, so I just actually use this opportunity to build a little cardio and thing.
But can you remember Mickey Chutman as a player? Can you remember him back in his days?
Man, watching one or two games of him and thing, as I see Petia down there, I remember him immediately.
Bring back some nice memories. Fun memories, great player.
Good player. Solid player.
And that's it, gone too soon. And especially in terms of sports and football, we have to remember life.
Of course, you know what I mean? It's all attached entertainment and, you know, football has always been attached, so we come out here to support him, you know?
What advice would you give to young people as regards to sport? You being an entertainer, but as regards to sport and the involvement in sports and balancing sport with life?
Well, life have a lot to do with sport, you know. A lot of them would, you know, think, you know, the skill level is the most important part of it. And when they reach into the real world, you'll realize that, you know, academics have a lot to do with football and where you're going to get with it, because football is a business now. Yes. So, you know, I would encourage them to stay in school and keep in alignment and keep it well balanced, you know.
What sport did you play when you were going to school?
Well, I was a footballer.
What position?
Left link.
And your fondest memories?
I enjoyed, I had a couple training sessions with Groovy from St. Anthony's. Yeah. I mean, he changed my whole perspective on football, you know, so it was an enjoyable thing to work in originally with my first high school coach, Mr. Creed.
And what is your favorite club presently?
My club is Real Madrid, you know. I enjoy watching football at Real Madrid because it's the highest form of Spanish football, if you ask me.
So once again, I want to say thank you very much to Zan and to Kitch. Yeah, thanks very much. We go and tape all
it. Keep him warm there.
We go and tape all it. So let's make sure you do the thing. Don't embarrass it. All right. So that was it. That was Kitch and Zan at the Mickey Chutman Memorial, Stefan and Mickey Chutman Memorial Football Tournament, being held at the Mickey Chutman Recreational Ground in Pinto Road, Arima. We'll be right back. And welcome back. We are joined by Mr. Clayton Ince, former national goalkeeper, who is here at the Mickey Chutman Memorial Tournament at the Mickey Chutman Recreational Ground at Pinto Road in Arima. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon and welcome.
So tell me your purpose of being present at this tournament.
Well, Mickey is one of Trinidad godsend players who really blesses the country with his ability. You know what I mean? I played with him at the World Cup level, qualifiers and stuff, and he was really an inspiration to the team. And to lose him at a very young age is really hurtful, but you know what I mean, we will always remember him, and that's why we come here all the time.
How do you feel seeing that persons from near and far have made their way down to Pinto Road on the ground that represents his name to be a part of this venture?
Well, as again, he's the person who connects the dots to everybody, and the love that we had for him and we have for him still, you know what I mean, we'll always remember it, and we'll always come here and show our solidarity to him and his family.
As we speak about Defence Force and Defence Force Masters, Defence Force Masters are two-time champions of the Tobago Masters Football Tournament. It is rumoured that you may be joining them, or you are still in talks with your management to be joining them for the Masters Tournament in Tobago to be held on 21st and 23rd. Can you tell us more about that?
Well, right now we're in talks with our management, and my agent is making sure that he has the best squad for me to represent, and we left to be seen.
What about the Tobago Masters that attract you to the event?
Well, you know what I mean, I give support to Tobago Masters because I've been playing in Barbados. I play with the English Masters, so it's about time, you know what I mean, I give something back to Tobago too. If they just go and represent all over the world, but they need to go to Tobago and share the love too, and I'm sure people in Tobago like to see me play, and it is a joy and it's really nice to be in Tobago.
Do you see more sport tourism ventures for that age group of over 40? Do you welcome such more events of that kind?
Yes, I welcome it, and I will partake in it as much as I could, because I think in that era, if you look at it, there's still a love among each other, and there's still a great amount of respect for the senior footballers who really put this this time of football for us, because without them, we wouldn't be where we are right now.
At this time, we wanted to set any closing comments as regards to Trinidad Tobago as we go on to qualifiers for the 2018 World Cup, as well as to the other young national teams who are in preparation. Any closing words to Trinidad Tobago as regards to football in the whole and the sporting landscape of Trinidad Tobago?
Well, all I'll say is Trinidad and Tobago, keep supporting your local sportsmen and be 100% behind them. And for the youngsters, keep focus on your goals and your dreams and your aspire to be at the best as you could be, and don't let nothing deter you from it.
We are here with Gary Glasgow at the Mickey Chutman Memorial Football Tournament and the Mickey Chutman Recreational Ground, Pinto Road in Arima. Good afternoon, Gary.
Afternoon.
You are here to celebrate a former national player. Tell me more about your relationship with Mickey Chutman.
We come from a long way. We grew up under 14, playing with national under 14, come straight up through the ranks. So he's like a brother. His mother, his aunt, they treat me as family, you know. So, you know, it's family, all love. I mean, the turnout is not what I expected. We expected to be more, because Mickey was a love fella, you know. As well as Stefan, his brother. I mean, we talk about Mickey, but we have to remember Stefan as well. Turnout is not as we expected, but as the evening goes on, I think it is gonna get bigger. You know, Trini's like to come out a little late. You know, the sun's still up, so you know they won't come out as yet. So we'll see how it goes.
What would you like this memorial to? What would you like to see this memorial in the next 5 years?
What would I like it to be
in the next 5 years?
Bigger and better, you know. I mean, this is a guy that was doing stuff for Trinidad as well as Pinto, you know. So I would like him to be recognized more. I mean, he's not here with us, but his kids, you know, his family, you know, like recognize them and you know, appreciate what he did for us then in his time that he was here.
We're just going to ask a few questions about the Tobago Masters Football Tournament. What are your initial thoughts about a tournament such as that, a sport tourism tournament such as that, being held for the over 40s?
Well, from what I heard, it's nice. You know, I've never been. I now turn 40. This is going to be my first one. Go as well in that. Everything goes as planned. But from hearing friend about it from my co-players, you know, Arnold Doric and them, I hear it's nice, and I think it's a positive. You know, we need to market it more, you know, because I went to Orlando and I played anyone in Orlando in January, and it's just tremendous out there, you know. And I think we need to market our stuff better and have teams come in from outside, abroad, and play in it. I think it'll be good for us.
Any closing words, Gary?
No, that's it, you know. Thanks for coming here and covering this, you know, because I think we need more of this to help build it.
We consider you a master of the game, and right now Tobago Masters Football Tournament want to recognize you as a master of the game. We want to say thank you very much for your contribution to the sporting landscape and football landscape of Trinidad and Tobago. So we want to say thank you very much for having us on it. We are joined with Dejon and Mr. Brian Bain, Dejon Plaza. How do you feel to be a part of this venture?
Well, I feel good. It was good. The match was good. No wild tackles.
I heard that you scored the only goal of the tournament. How does that make you feel?
Make me feel good. Make me feel as if I could have an experience to be like John Wayne Jones.
Well done. And what school do you attend?
Arima Boys RC.
And how old are you?
9 years old.
What are your expectations as a footballer? Where do you see yourself going in football?
I see myself going with the national team of Trinidad and Tobago.
Great. And what club do you support?
I support Chelsea and Real Madrid.
May I ask why, and who is your favorite player?
Favorite player is Cristiano Ronaldo. And I guess like how they display.
So that's why. So what is there any reason that you like Cristiano Ronaldo?
Yes, because he is most accurate at the game. He knows how to play the game.
Mr. Bain, tell me more about your program and tell me about your involvement in the Mickey Chutman Memorial Football Tournament.
Well, thanks again. You know, thanks again for the invite. My involvement as a true Pintorian, so to speak, cut my playing time short. I was aspiring, as most kids growing up, to be a professional footballer. You know, cut my playing time short, decided, you know what, in Pinto Road there isn't any organization to say, well, you know, this is the way you do it to be the next Russell Atapi, the next Dwight York, the next Brian Lara, the next Atto Boland, so to speak. My love is for football. I decided, you know what, myself and other persons in the community who played as well, you know, we decided let's start this sports club, Pinto United Sports Club. The intention was to get all sports discipline eventually, you know, hence the name Sports Club, Pinto United Sports Club. To get the ball rolling, we started with football. My coaching staff consists of myself presently, and I can't forget none other than Dexter Hoyt, commonly called Decky, you know, who's a past player at the Arima Comprehensive Intercol Football also. In terms of getting involved here, being the person I am, the president of the Pinto United Sports Club, and highly active in football, the new achievers, the Chatman family, invited me to be a part of the committee in terms of getting this tournament and this memorial football extravaganza done. The sports club, we have been in existence for probably unofficial. We had an unofficial year, which was 2010. And we officially started in 2011. One of our past players is presently representing Trinidad and Tobago, presently representing Trinity College East, presently represented his family, presently represented the Pinto United Sports Club on a football scholarship with FIFA University. His name is Nathan Regis. In terms of his achievements thus far, records. I think he broke a goal scoring record from since 1965. It was remarkable. That's just one out of the many records. Pinto United involvement in getting him there was the jump start of getting him there in terms of assisting him and guiding him in terms of getting the SAT exam done, in terms of, you know, talking of experience, what is expected if you want to get a football scholarship, what is expected when you get the football scholarship. It's a proud moment for myself, it's a proud moment for the club, and I can tell you it did inspire all the other Pinto members, you know, it make them see that they can do it too, where academics is concerned and football is concerned. Mickey himself was an inspiration for me. I took up the challenge of myself, saying, well, hey, if Mickey is from Pinto and Mickey could do it, who is Brian B, and I could do it also, you know.
How do you feel that he's been remembered by his community, by his family, by his friends?
I feel good, you know. I feel good. I think this should continue. I think the immediate community and the Trinidad community by extension should, you know, we should honor it. He was a role model to the Pinto, and I'm sure other communities in Trinidad and Tobago, you know, this will do well. This will do well for the younger ones, like as Dejan is here, and the younger ones, you know, the little knowledge that they would have of Mickey, you know, that they can do it also. So it should. I love it. I love it, and I welcome it.
So we are joined by this youngster. Come in. Can you tell me your name, please?
Oriel.
Pardon?
Oriel.
Oriel. So Oriel, tell me your reason for being at the Mickey Chatman Recreational Ground.
I have no reason.
Pardon?
I have no reason.
You have no reason? You didn't play football today with the cool kids?
Yes.
And who won the game?
Pinto.
What is your position?
Forward.
You play forward. So how come you didn't score the goal to equalize or to go on and win?
I don't know.
So you want to take the time to recognize both Dejan, both these two brilliant, the future generation of Trinidad and Tobago, as well as Mr. Brian Bain. Thank you, Mr. Bain, for joining us as we represent Mickey Chatman. You remember him at the name of the recreational ground, Mickey Chatman Recreational Ground at Pinto Road.
I get up from my bed, accident on Pinto Road. Everybody get up now. What's that? I could never forget that man. Hey, what's up with Mickey Chatman? Oh, he came here, and he put the head on, so, bullshit! And he started to run, so, You know him?
No, he's celebration, yeah?
But you put a head or so. Yeah, Dana. Just like everybody start to run to meet his top man.
That's good, good. Come on, I'm gonna go.
And we are back after a light moment with Mr. Stern John. Good afternoon, sir.
Afternoon, Bob.
We are here at Mickey Chotman's Memorial. Mm-hmm. Tell me your purpose for being here.
I think Mickey is one of my bestest friend from growing up from childhood. And I think today is just, it's an emotional day. It's also a day to celebrate his life too. I think he left a legacy. He's one of those guys that always full of vibes, you know? And when you remember Mickey as the person he was, he's such a tremendous guy, you know? He always come out and full of love, and everybody loved him. They loved him. We started from young, but then we played together in New Orleans, and New Orleans Rubber Gamblers. And when I was younger, I never used to pepper. So we had a pre-match ritual we used to do. So the team used to go to Olive Garden. Obviously, being from Trinidad, we never liked pasta and this and that. So we was young, you know what I mean? Inexperienced. So we used to go to Olive Garden, and we never eat the pasta. We used to go back to the house and cook corned beef and rice. So Mickey knew I never used to eat pepper, and from purpose, he put pepper in the food. And there's a day before the game, but we ended up falling out a couple hours. But just before the game start, you know, obviously there's a love between us. So yeah, I mean, it was one of them things was funny. It was real funny.
You being a forward, Mickey being a midfielder. Tell me the connection on the field of play.
Oh yeah, Mickey Chotman, he played for his teammates. Played for us. Me playing forward, I needed to get Silvers to score. And he's one of the guys who used to work hard. He was an engine room. He worked his socks off and gave the ball. And Silvers was fantastic. I think players nowadays, they said, emulate like how Mickey used to play. I think he's one of those guys, he played for his team. Like I say, he worked hard as a midfielder, and he supplied as strikers to score goals.
You played with a lot of top-notch teams and with a lot of top-notch players. Where would you class Mickey in all of that?
Yeah, he's one of my top five players I played. One of the top five. Arguably one of the top five players. I think a lot of people never really see him play. But I saw him play, we play a youth team football together, we play Integral together, and we play international football together as well. I think a lot of people didn't get a chance to see how good he was. I think he was a fantastic player. I mean, he will always tell the youngsters to keep their foot on the ground. I think we have a lot of our youths nowadays, especially in Trinidad, as soon as they play a couple of games and they get a little bit of success, tend to go to our heads too. And I think that's in Trinidad too. I think we tend to spoil our youth players by telling them that they're good and they can play. Because I walk around Trinidad and people always tell me like, this guy good and we never heard of him before. How can he be good? He haven't been on the world stage. So my message through Mickey for the youngsters nowadays is just to keep your head and keep your foot on the ground.
And keep smiling.
Yeah, keep smiling and enjoy life.
What do you think organizations can do more as regards to using sport, especially since you have been in football, to getting more persons to the island of Trinidad and Tobago?
I think sports, football, sports in general is a massive part in our country. I think you've seen sports and they bring countries together. They bring all the world leaders together. So why can't we do it in Trinidad? I think we need to market sports a bit more. I need to get involved. And like you said, everyone talk about grassroots. We need to get involved and tap into the younger youths. Because I think the younger youths, they need to be part of something. If you look around here today, it's only youths. And I think if we have more of these stuff, the youths and them will have something to do and they will be part of something.
How do you feel being considered a master of the game?
Well, I think I'm lost for words, actually, because I think in Trinidad, they tend to not recognize the guys who've done well for Trinidad and Tobago. I think we tend to get a lot of love outside of Trinidad and more recognition. But I think it's a good feeling for you to see that today. I humbly welcome it. Like I said, I would like to continue giving back to Trinidad as much as I can because we have a lot of talent here. We just need to tap into it. And we just need to just keep working on youths and don't give up on them. But they are the
future. Well, let's say thank you very much to Mr. Stern John, master of the game. And the bestest friend to Mickey Chotman, as we wind down at the Mickey Chotman Recreational Ground to honor the great Mickey Chotman and his brother Stefan Chotman on this beautiful day, October the 1st. We want to remind everybody that football is life, and also life is important and precious, and we should always remember to take time to praise God, keep family close, keep friends close, and create great memories. So as we say thank you very much on behalf of the Mickey Chotman family, we want to say great job, and to all in Trinidad and Tobago, love and blessings. So we are back with Mr. Kendall Velux, former St. Vincentian striker and lover of football, lover of Trinidad and Tobago. Welcome, Mr. Velux.
Yeah, it's nice Trinidad. The passion of football is very high and, you know, I love it.
You are here at the Mickey Chutman Recreational Ground to honor Mickey and his brother, who died 15 years ago. Have you ever had any encounter with Mickey?
Well, I had an opportunity to meet him once and in Joe Public Football Club, and after he passed, I get to play in his number, so, you know, that's the closest I get to him.
You have one leading goal scorer 2 years in a row. How did that feel, rolling back the hands of time and being able to showcase your skill, which obviously never left you, but to do it on that stage, how did it feel?
Well, first of all, as a team player, you know, I got to win any championship, but to get most goal in a tournament is just a bonus for me.
What are your expectations for the 2016 edition of the Masters Football Tournament? And what do you want out of the tournament?
Well, first of all, I know Tobago Masters is a tremendous tournament. So with Juventus, we're looking to come and take back the Tobago Masters. And I know the Tobago Masters is a very professional organized tournament.
We want to recognize you as a master of the game. How do you feel to be classified as one of the masters of the game in Trinidad and Tobago?
Well, it's a great honor to be classified as a master's player, but when I go out there to play, it's to go and play for the love of the game.
So we want to say thank you very much to Mr. Kendall Velux, former Vincentian national striker, and also well-known person in the Masters circuit in Trinidad and Tobago, no stranger to the shows of Trinidad and Tobago, who have continued to add it to the landscape of football in Trinidad and Tobago through playing and also coaching. So I want to say thank you very much, Mr. Velux.
I don't want to cry. I'm not going to cry. But Mickey was my first son. You couldn't ask for a better child. Always loving, always caring, you know, concerned about his other brothers and sisters. He loved everybody. He would always hug and kiss. Soon as he see his teachers would say, oh gosh, Miss Shortman, I don't know how to correct this boy, you know, because he always hugging and kissing, you know, full of love. I've never seen Mickey vex. I've never seen him upset or displeased with anybody or for anything. He have always been a happy young man.
Have you any memories as a mother with a boy child who loves football? What is your memory of him in terms of, have you running away from home to play football, having to wash your dirty clothes? Tell us some fun memories of you as a mother to a national footballer.
Yeah, every day I would have to call him from this savannah, every day, because we live just probably about 100 feet away from the recreation ground, and every day he would be here. I would have to come and get him in the night because we wasn't fortunate at that time to have street lights. So it was coming and get him. Mickey, come on, boy, come from the field. Every day he would go and run away and go and play football. I was telling his nephew, you know, Mickey would go leave home on a Saturday and I wouldn't see him until Saturday night. Because 1 minute he'd say he in Kumoto playing, he in Arima playing, he had Eddie Hart playing, or he with Alvin Coneal playing. So Mickey would spend the whole day playing football. The dirty clothes, I don't have to tell you. Probably Lever Brothers get plenty money from me because I always had to buy soap to clean up his clothes.
We had asked to ask the normal questions. The first time your son got the opportunity to travel for football, how did you feel?
Oh, I felt very proud. He was only 9 years old. He was only 9 years old when he was given that opportunity by Alvin Coneal. And he went to Caracas. I gave him his little pocket money and he spent all the money on food. He couldn't understand what they were saying. So everything they asked him, if he want this, he said yes. And when he finished, he had no money. All the money spent was for food.
Mickey Chutman is well known in Arima country.
Oh yes.
Larger than life when it came to interclub football.
Yes.
As a mother in the stands, but everybody shouting your son's name or celebrating his victories. It obviously felt good, but tell us something besides good that nobody knows in terms of how you felt.
Me? I felt so proud, eh? I don't think I have enough words to explain how proud I was of Mickey, because he would always make you proud. Me and my sisters would be there, probably first in the velodrome, Arima Velodrome, to cheer him on. And we would be calling him, Mickey, Mickey, go on, go on. And he wouldn't look at us, because he know we right there supporting, and we want to let him know where he went wrong. And boy, it was the proudest moments of my life, going to the stadium to watch Mickey play Intercol, and then making not only Pinto Road, but the community of Arima proud.
Yeah, very much so. Every time you pass, you see his name as recognized on a recreational ground, the same recreational ground that he played, he ran away from home. How that makes you feel every time you see your son's name on a piece of concrete that symbolizes the love he had for this place?
I feel very elated. I feel very proud as a mother to see, you know, that his name is there. He's still standing out in the community. I feel very proud.
How do you see his legacy living on in your grandchildren, in the other kids that you have?
Oh, yes. Well, Ori, Stefan was also a great footballer. He never got the opportunity that Mickey got, but he was also a great footballer. Kenyan, well, he got damaged in the accident also, so he no longer plays professionally, you know, for Trinidad. But my daughter, she played national hockey also, and she did so great after Mickey passed on. She, like, all her energies was placed into the hockey. She did well. She went in the World Cup. And then I have my grandson, which is Kenyan's son, my grandson, Kareem Trotman. He represented Arima Boys RC. You know, he was the captain of Arima Boys RC last year, and he did proud. He scored the winning goal for Arima to win the East Zone.
We have a situation right now where young people, as you see, are very defiant in our society. And you speak about Mickey, who never disrespected you. The only thing he did was run away for football, but that was his love. What would you tell parents as regards to keeping their children on the straight and narrow and getting their involvement in sports?
Parents need to support their children. They need to go out there, know their friends, go out and watch them play, support them. Because when children don't have any support from their parents, they listen to other people, and then they get carried away with the wrong ideas and the wrong things. But I have supported my children from day one. I would go to all their football games. I would let them know when they played good, when they played bad. And, you know, I've all my family on the whole, we are real family oriented. We love sports. We get them involved in sports, and we continue to support them. And I think support and getting to know your children and their friends is a great way to go.
As we close, we want to say thank you very much, ma'am. On behalf of Acts 25, we want to say God is with you. He has given you the strength over the last 15 years, and he'll continue to give you the strength from in time to come. We know that this tournament and this event will go from strength to strength, so we wish you and your family many of God's blessings.
Thank you.
And we hope to see you next year again as we continue to highlight the Mickey Trotman Memorial Tournament to pay homage to this former national youth player, as well as his brother who died in a car accident many years ago at the ground that is named after him, the Mickey Trotman Recreational Ground, Pinto Road, Arima. So I want to say thank you very much and have a good evening.